to team-related activities that you can share?
No news.
No news. All right. There was a story out yesterday with a Spanish outlet talking about you had promised to Joseph that you would help him try to get back to you.
Yes.
I'm assuming that conversation took place when he had first arrived. Is my first question about that.
That was the one. Sí. Pregunta es si eso fue una de las primeras charlas que tuve.
Sí, la primera.
The first one.
La primera.
Is that a conversation y'all have had recently?
Y últimamente.
No.
No.
Nunca más.
Okay.
Never again.
Porque porque después o se ayuda o no se ayuda y él tiene que hacer lo que está haciendo, así que esa es la única forma. Se habla una sola vez.
No, you can only say it once, and since then, you know, I can try to help, but he's doing everything by himself on the field.
Okay. And I know you've also made that pledge to Miguel. Have you made it to anyone else?
Dice que también has dicho como la misma promesa a Miguel, y si lo has dicho a alguien más.
No, en realidad, con Joseph la conversación fue, bueno, compromiso de ayudarlo a volver a Europa, y Miguel está tratando de ir a Europa por primera vez. Creo que es un recorrido lógico. Seríamos todos muy injustos si pretendemos que un jugador con tanta proyección y tan joven termine su carrera aquí. Él tiene que cumplir como mínimo el desafío de poder probarse con los mejores, así que me parece que son diferentes situaciones.
Yeah, with Joseph, my commitment was to help him get back to Europe. With Miguel, it's to try to help Miguel get to Europe for the first time. And I think it'd be unfair to think anything else. I think that's the logical progression for him. You know, he came here as a young player, and I think that, you know, at the very least, a player of his age and his great projection, you know, that he wants that challenge to play against the best players in Europe.
Y además me parece que también es un lindo desafío para Atlanta United ver cómo continuamos esa rueda. Es decir, trajimos dos de los mejores de la liga, eventualmente se irán esos dos mejores de la liga con un buen negocio para el club, y el desafío es volver a encontrar otros futbolistas que lleguen a cumplir el mismo rol que hoy cumplen tanto Joseph como Miguel.
Yeah, and I think it's a nice challenge for Atlanta United because we've brought in two of the best players in the league. So now eventually those players will leave, so the next step is to see how you can keep that circle going and to bring in the next players, and hopefully we can bring in another two or however many great players.
Just so I'm clear, this isn't a pledge that you've had with Barco or with Franco or Andrew about helping them get
Julian.
Julian.
It is possible. Yes.
That they
Why not?
But I'm just trying to. You haven't said.
No significa que no significa que se van a ir todos juntos, y mucho menos que se van a ir todos juntos cuando yo diga. Yo creo que está bien que el club trabaje en eso. Futbolistas que sean buenos, que rindan en el club, que logren el objetivo con el club y que el día de mañana busquen el desafío mayor, que seguramente es jugar en el fútbol europeo. Y el club seguir trabajando con la academia para promover jugadores y eventualmente contratar jugadores extranjeros que vuelvan a repetir el mismo círculo.
Yeah, that doesn't mean that they're all going to leave together or that they're all going to leave while I'm still the coach, but it means that you know, those players that, you know, they want to test themselves against the best, and then it's the, you know, the job of the club to promote or bring up guys through the academy so that they can you know, fill in for those spots. Más o menos, ¿no?
Sí, no, me parece que no. La diferencia es que el fútbol, el soccer en Estados Unidos no es igual que la NBA o el fútbol americano. El fútbol americano y la NBA es lo mejor del mundo aquí. Entonces el jugador no busca ir al lugar top. Ya está en el lugar top. En el fútbol tiene esa necesidad de ir a buscar ese lugar, sobre todo si tienes condiciones.
Yeah, he says it's different than the NBA or the NFL in the U.S. because those are the top leagues. So players here, they don't have to think about going anywhere else because they're already at the top. But soccer is different. So, you know, the top leagues are in Europe, and players, if they want to play against the best, then they have to test themselves there.
I actually understood all of that.
On Miguel, you said recently he might be having a better season this year than last year. Is that the case? And also, what has he improved on since last season?
¿Tú crees que Miguel está teniendo una mejor temporada este año y en qué ha mejorado?
Miguel hace tantas cosas bien que es muy difícil. Yo creo que ha mejorado en cada uno de los aspectos. Ha mejorado en su situación, en llegar al área, tener situaciones de gol, más allá que a lo mejor no ha tenido la efectividad acorde a las situaciones que tuvo y que se creó. Sigue teniendo el mismo compromiso y más a la hora de trabajar para recuperar la pelota. Empezó hace un tiempo a saber manejar los dos. Digamos, justamente los tiempos del equipo, de cuándo atacar, de cuándo no, que es algo que él necesita imperiosamente incorporar como una parte muy importante de su juego. Y en realidad lo que también pasa es que nosotros nos centramos en Miguel y nos centramos en Joseph, pero en realidad creo que el equipo está haciendo una mejor temporada que la anterior.
Miguel does so many things well that it's really hard to say, but I think he's improved in every aspect of his game. I think he's getting into the box more and getting into goal-scoring situations. I think maybe he hasn't had the effectiveness that he would want in some of those chances, but I think he's getting into great positions. Also, he's always been doing well at this, but he's great at recovering the ball, tracking back defensively. And I think recently he's learning to have that understanding of when to do both, when to get forward and then when to track back, which is important. But I think, you know, him and Joseph, you could say that the team as a whole is just better this season, and those guys are part of it.
Un poco para completar esta pregunta y la pregunta anterior de Doc. Y es cierto, antes hablábamos de Jose, hablábamos de Miguel, de Ezequiel, de Julian, de Andrew, de Franco, pero también todo lo que ha pasado este año tiene una garantía en pilares y en soportes que tiene este equipo y que son Brad, Parky, Jeff, Leandro, y no hay que... toda estructura necesita un pilar importante, y nuestro pilar importante es esa columna vertebral que forman el holding midfielder, los backs y el arquero.
Yeah, just to kind of conclude with this thought and also your question before, there's also, we're talking about all those young guys, but there's also some very important pillars on this team, and every team needs a structure that allows the team to be successful, and for us it's that spine with Brad, the two center backs, Parky and Leandro, and Jeff in holding midfield.
We've talked about the future of some of the players. I wanted to ask you about your future. You have an option coming up. You're at the first part of your contract, ends at the end of this season. Can you give us a status update?
My future.
Well, your contract.
Not important.
It's a little bit important.
No. No, nada que nos distraiga del objetivo nuestro, eso.
No, nothing that's going to distract us from our goal this season.
Red Bull sigue ganando y ese es nuestro objetivo, nada más que eso.
Red Bulls keep winning, so that's our main goal right now.
Have you been in communication with anyone about it? Have you been talking to anyone at the club about options?
Siempre hablamos con el club de las opciones futuras, siempre, permanentemente.
Always. We're permanently talking with those at the club about the options.
What is your deadline?
No. No comment.
No, he's said all he's going to say.